Hey everyone, this is a roughly 50 times sped up view of me working on my custom Lego shell gas station that I originally put together in 2013 and later added on to a bit to add a service garage element to it for my original Lego city. And it was originally very specifically designed to fit in a very particular space with a peculiar shape and inside corner with a diagonal element to it. Well, in New Jang City, that corner is no longer available for this. I finally decided where I do want to put this over by my industrial area, and it's going to fit onto a more traditional rectangular plot. So you're looking at me reconfiguring what existed already, transferring some stuff from one set of base plates to another with different shapes and different offsets, changing the proportions of some things, and in a minute you'll see me really rebuilding a wing of the service garage, kind of the front office section of it or showroom section of it. I just put the camera in an overhead position and let it go, and you will actually see that reflected just a little bit in the skylight, but I really needed to not care about the camera at all, so my apologies for kind of the angle, not showing you all of the details here, but hopefully at least it gives you an idea of the overall work that went into this and kind of the process I went through. I brought out a bunch of stickers because as I was going through this, I realized that a number of the stickers I had used had begun to decay. They had begun to dry up and curl and peel and crack. There was a period of Lego's history when they made stickers with a specific material that, when subject to certain environmental conditions, would peel and crack, and it made everybody hate stickers just in general, even though most of the stickers they've made over their history have worked out pretty well. I actually ended up not using any new ones. I found enough, or unused ones, I found enough pieces that already had stickers or had prints on them to take care of everything that I needed to do for now, but I did go ahead on to BrickLink after this and order up a new sticker sheet for a specific Shell gas station official set that I really needed some specific decals from. But what I'm working on right now in this corner, you see in that upper right corner, is just a sign that goes above the door. It was a little bit tricky to fit something into that diagonal space. I've never used that corner, that relatively new corner door frame piece before, and had no idea what its proportions really were. So that was just a little bit tricky there. But this has ended up with a much smaller space for the showroom that I'm working on there, but it really didn't need any more space than that. It's just a place for customers to come in and to basically sign off on the work they want to have done on their vehicles. In this video, I do most of the work, but a little bit of the extra detail stuff and some of the tiling of the road is left after this. I kind of do that offline, but you will see. I'll give you a full view of this whole thing. Nice normal speed walk through it and show you the interior once it's done, which will be very soon. So that was just that. A lot of people have asked to see kind of my work in progress, especially on custom stuff. I don't want to do any live building because I feel like that will be ridiculously boring to everyone, but hopefully this time lapse lets you see some of the work in progress without boring you completely to death. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for the completed full walkthrough of the updated service station. Catch you later.